Horses teach you character. You learn responsibility from having a horse. How to care for an animal, which transcends to caring for the family. A horse can be a friend, a companion. The horse will understand that and will stand by you. A horse can be a disciplinarian. That's why you be good to your horse, and it's going to help you.
Saddle up, settle in. Every story must begin, and this one is tall, but it's true. It starts as a quest to tell the tales of the West, and how it ends, well, nobody knows but you. Tell us a good one tonight while the fire's burning bright, about mountains and rivers of gold. Sing us a good one tonight, neath the moon's silver light, full of tall tales and legends. Roll the blankets out on the ground as our shadows grow taller than trees. There ain't nothing for miles, so the stories run wild and the songs can roam anywhere they please. Tell us a good one tonight while the fire's burning bright, about mountains and rivers of gold. Sing us a good one tonight, neath the moon's silver light, full of tall tales and legends of old. Move 'em out, move 'em in. Every story has to end, but some stay in your heart. They go round and round, they get lost and then found, 'cause the end is just another place to start.
Count me off.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
One, two, three, four.
Having grown up in the West, Joe and I have certainly experienced a lot of Colorado.
But coming out here for 30 days and traveling through 5 or 6 different states,
starting down in the Navajo Nation in Arizona and going all the way up into Wyoming,
gave us a whole different feel for what it's like to be in the West. So this trip has a focus around the Great Divide, or the Continental Divide, which is all the highest points along the Rocky Mountain Range.
On one side, all the rivers flow to the east part of the country, and on the other, they all flow to the west.
So my water will go that way and yours will go that way?
Yeah, I'll send mine to the Gulf of Mexico and the Atlantic Ocean.
I'll send mine to the Pacific Ocean. Wow, would you look at that? We started down south, where it was red canyons and desert. It was very dry.
There's some of the most classic parks, like the Grand Canyon.
Wow.
And Zion. And Bryce National Park.
And then all of a sudden we were in the sand dunes, which are just humongous dunes of sand. And from there, going into Colorado and the Rocky Mountains, all the way out here to Wyoming. So we felt like we accomplished our goal of trying to see as much of the West and the Continental Divide region as we could.
A lot of the national parks we visited are very recognizable. In fact, you see them on postcards and movies. There were some smaller state parks and national parks that aren't as recognizable.
We were in Canyon de Chelly National Park. It is such a hidden gem out there in the Navajo Nation.
You have to have a Navajo guide.
They're huge red rock surfaces.
We saw old petroglyphs. Petroglyphs are drawings on the walls.
And they're thousands of years old.
We could see that the Anasazi people, who were there before the Navajo, lived in the walls of the canyon. We even got to ride horses through the canyon. On these adventures that we go on, we like to choose a unique form of transportation: canoeing, hiking. For horses, it's a whole different ball game.
We didn't really know how to ride horses very well.
Justin and I aren't cowboys.
So we spent a little time before the trip practicing, riding some horses, learning how to saddle up a horse. We've needed some help because we don't own horses, we don't know that much about horses, and we don't know that much about this area where we're riding. So we've got our guide. His name is Dave.
We're here with Dave Mapes today, our backcountry guide. He's been leading us around all these different trails back here near the Continental Divide.
I take people in the mountains all summer on horseback trips, and I just give people enjoyment being up in the mountains.
So you're a real live cowboy?
I don't mess with cows. I call myself a horseman. I like to play with horses, and I like to ride in the mountains.
You've got a camp here. Tell us a little bit about what you do when you're not out on a horse.
In the morning, I get up earlier and get breakfast rolling.
Blueberries.
Call the horses in. We usually take a pack horse.
A pack horse is a horse that you don't ride. It has a special saddle. It just gets everything where it needs to be. And to do that, we use panniers. They're big bags. You basically fill the bags with what you need. And then we cover it with tarps because of the rain. The whole point of it is just so that you're more comfortable on your horse instead of having to carry all your stuff.
And you do the cooking too, huh?
Yeah.
You like cooking over a fire?
I do.
Yeah?
Yeah, I burned a lot of stuff when I was learning years ago. Kind of got the knack of it. And we always eat good, fresh vegetables.
All right, kids, eat your veggies.
Well, this is a wilderness area. We're not allowed to bring anything mechanical in here. You're not allowed to bring bicycles in here. Everything is old-fashioned. We're cutting wood with saws and axes over there.
Cutting wood for the fire.
This is a great area to ride in. You don't see people very often. It's really nice back here. I like it a lot.
While you're out on the horse, there's a lot of time to think. A big part of this trip is writing songs, just like it has been on all our other trips. We get out here to try to find inspiration.
Something about being in the presence of all of these big things out here in the West, the Rocky Mountains are big, the sky is big, the clouds are big, makes us really start to notice the little things. It was funny, I'm not sure exactly how it started, but we decided to grab our little camera and we would set it up to record our little songs.
Some serious ones.
There's a great divide that makes the rivers and the rains flow to the Western Ocean or run through the Eastern Plains.
Some are funny.
All right, all set. Here's a little tune we wrote about our favorite instrument.
You can chug. You can bend. You can start. You can end. It's my new harmonica. I got it for Hanukkah.
Some sort of bad ones.
It's called same word rhyming, and it sounds good too. With same word rhyming, you can write songs too.
Some are just beautiful little moments.
Come a cow, cow, yippee, come a cow, cow, yay. A cow, cow, yippee, yippee, yay.
You know the old Western saying, it's easy to say whatever you mean. The hard part is saying it with as few words as possible.
I'm counting all the clouds in the sky. I'm counting all the leaves on the trees. I'm counting all the birds and the buffalo herds. And
And I'm wondering if they're counting on me. I used to drive a Cadillac right down the passing lane. I drove it round that city till it drove me insane. So I swapped it for a pickup truck that I could drive out on the range. But when I saw that beautiful country, I sold that truck for change. Now I just drive cattle from a leather-seated saddle. Comes equipped with four-leg drive, long as she can stay alive. Always have the windows down as I go riding around with the radio ringing, or am I just singing? First gear is walking, second gear is a trot. Lope and gallop are three and four, but we don't use those a lot. She's got a 1-horsepower engine, and her shocks ain't worth a darn. But I'd rather have her out with me than parked in some old barn. So I just drive cattle from a leather-seated saddle. Comes equipped with four-leg drive, long as she can stay alive. Always have the windows down as I go riding around with the radio ringing, or am I just singing? She's Lone Star safety rated, even comes voice activated. The giddy up will get her to go. They hit the brakes, just yell out, whoa, Nelly. Now I just drive cattle from a leather-seated saddle. Comes equipped with four-leg drive, long as she can stay alive. Always have the windows down as I go riding around with the radio ringing, or am I just singing with the radio ringing? Am I just singing songs that keep her right on course? 'Cause she's a highfalutin, rootin, tootin, slow commutin, non-pollutin, 1-horsepower, 2 miles an hour, 1-horsepower horse.
My four-string banjo here. I broke one of the strings out on a horse, but I'll sing you a song anyway. Ramblin' Pete was a talkative man. He rambled as he rambled all across the land. So with his horse all packed, Pete continued to yak. And he loved his horse 'cause he never talked back.
We're here with our friend Bridget today in Cody, Wyoming, learning about how to be a cowgirl and or a cowboy. Good point. What do you have in your hand there?
A lariat.
A lariat. You want to teach us a little bit about what this is all about?
You try to roll your wrists.
Okay, we'll be over here trying to roll.
Is this it? Are you doing this right? No?
Your spoke is not
right.
Oh,
this is a little more difficult than I thought it was.
Man, why does mine always get crossed up like that? Looks like an 8. See that? Yeah!
All right, Bridget. You got it.
Had to see somebody do it.
Yeah.
I got you, Alex.
Do you know what a jackalope is?
A jackalope? Mm-hmm. Isn't that, aren't those the...
It's a rabbit with horns, basically.
Antelope horns.
Jackrabbit with horns.
Have you seen a jackalope?
I've heard of him. I've never seen one.
No.
So many. You just see them everywhere.
Really?
My grandma raises them.
Tucker and I, we go
some.
Chase them all the time.
You go chasing them?
How big are they?
They're little. You know.
Yeah, they're about that long, about that big around.
Size of a kitten.
Like this?
A kitten?
Okay. How about the antlers?
Usually like that.
Okay.
A couple inches.
No, smaller. About like smaller. That.
They're not antlers?
They're horns?
They're horns.
Or are they antlers?
I think they're horns.
Okay, we're going with horns.
They're horns.
Goes without saying that you believe in jackalopes.
Of course.
Yeah, I believe in jackalopes.
Yeah, I think I believe in jackalopes.
You know, there are some people out there that don't believe in jackalopes.
I think they're out there.
They make a certain sound.
Kind of
like that. Oh. There's a mysterious animal I'm looking for. They call it the jackalope. It's got the body of a jackrabbit and the antlers of an antelope. Some say they're fast, and some say they're slow. I've heard they're big, I've heard they're small. Seems like no one can ever agree. It's almost like they don't exist at all. Almost like they don't exist at all. They're only seen between midnight and 2 on leap years beneath a blue moon. When it's hot on the tundra and snowing in the desert on the 31st of June. Well, I've seen them in books and in taxidermy shops. I've seen them hanging on. But I ain't never seen one in the living light of day. It's almost like they don't exist at all. Yeah, it's almost like they don't exist at all. Jackalope.
We're sitting here with our friend Matt, fly fishing.
Okay, so how many flies did you catch today?
Do you fish for the flies as they buzz by you?
You fly for the fish.
You fly for the fish. Can you tell us what fly fishing is?
Fly fishing is fishing with feather and animal hair and thread tied onto it to look like a small fly.
So where do the worms come in? Do you fish with worms when you're fly fishing?
Usually you don't fish with worms.
No?
Hey, we're using these today.
These ones taste better.
We're gonna use those.
One of the things that's always a great challenge about fly fishing is there is no one right way to do it. That also means being prepared for a number of different situations, having your waders and your boots on so that you can get into the water if you need to. Patience is probably the most important thing about being a good fly fisher, because you're gonna get stuck in the trees and your line's gonna get tangled.
It takes two to tangle. Boy, and did I get tangled.
You really have to enjoy being outside, and your goal has to be to spend time in the outdoors, to be in nature, to be with friends if you can find friends who fly fish.
What's this for?
This is a net. It's getting the fish out of the water if you catch one.
Nice work.
This particular net is great. It's made out of this rubber, so it's really gentle on the fish.
Usually, do you take the fish out and fry it up and eat it?
I let the fish go.
The rainbow trout we got here. We're gonna let her go.
But also, I like to put them back so that other people have an opportunity to catch them as well. And we want to try and keep those populations nice and high so a lot of people can come out here and enjoy this.
How many fish did you catch today?
Caught one fish today.
Caught one fish. I caught one too. Justin?
I didn't catch any.
Justin didn't catch anything. So you're just sitting there, instead of fishing, you're doing some wishing, right?
Doing a lot of wishing. Wishing for some fish.
Wishing for some fish.
Dear Diary. You mind if I call you Diary? I know I used to call you Journal, but hey, it's nice to have a change every once in a while. I got a new hat lately. I've been wearing this old cowboy hat because we've been riding horses, you know. It looks pretty good on me. I think it's not so bad, right? I'm wearing my old jacket, too. Never fails. It does smell a little, though.
All right, well, I got the paper, got the pen. Now all it's going to take is maybe some ideas. Let's see here. What could I come up with? Seems like I'm just writing about writing. That's no good.
Wow, Joe sure is a good journaler. The way he nods his head and shakes his pen like that. Man, he must have already written like 25 songs already.
Well, to tell you the truth here, I'm drawing a blank. I don't have much to write about. I'm thinking about maybe sitting on a log, sitting next to my friend.
Maybe if I just turn off my brain and keep the pen moving, that'll do the trick. Yeah, this is good. The brain is off. No brain here.
Could write about the universe, the little bacteria under my toenails. Maybe Justin is thinking of something?
Yeah, I'm thinking of something, but it's all private.
Yeah, isn't it great to have all your thoughts to yourself?
Yeah, and not have to share everything.
I hear that.
Wait a second.
Could you hear all of that?
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
And if you can hear me, then...
maybe we can hear...
Sherman?
Hello.
Ooh. Ooh. Sounds nice in here. Great minds think alike, but the best minds think together.
Yeah, that sounded better in my head.
Well, today's the 4th of July, so we thought we'd celebrate with a little snowball fight.
Oh, yeah!
Oh.
Whoa!
We're standing out here with Carlos Medina today. Y los trios. No, I said it wrong. El trio Los Gallos. Okay. Y los trio. No!
Y el trio Los Gatos.
Gallos.
You want your shoes?
Gallos. Y el trio Los Gallos.
We're kind of a hybrid group, you know.
Sure.
We've merged mariachi and Norteño music.
Yeah, have you ever played with a banjo player before?
We never have, not together. This is cool, kind of merging two genres.
Let's introduce these instruments. What do you got there?
I got a vihuela. It's a mariachi instrument, 5 strings. Gives it a brighter sound because of the hump in the back, and that's what makes a vihuela.
All right. How about you, Carlos?
Accordion.
Show us what it sounds like here. What do you got over there?
I got a guitar.
Oh yeah, that looks kind of familiar, right? Yeah.
A little bit bigger than yours.
Right here I have a guitarrón. It has a big hump on the back, which gives it that low sound. Kind of similar to upright bass.
We're going to play a song for you that Justin and I wrote in Spanglish.
You want to do it too? Oh, here we go. Doesn't matter if you call it Stetson or a sombrero, it's the hat that steers the herd. Doesn't matter if you call them cowboys or vaqueros, the best ones keep their word. Doesn't matter if you say ma'am or señorita when you're riding into the setting sun. Doesn't matter if you call it life or la vida, it's better when you're with someone. Somos amigos con una distinta canción. Amigos, amigos, nos queremos por esta razón. No importa si se llama café o café, te despierta en las mañanas. No importa si se llama fate o la fe, pero puede mover montañas.
Let's hear it, Carlos. Bring it on.
Doesn't matter if you call it flag or bandera, it just tells you where you are. Doesn't matter if you call it border or frontera, it disappears by strumming a guitar. We're all amigos, each with a different song. Amigos, amigos, that's why.
Susanna, I'm home on the range, and I've been working on the railroad for the New York Stock Exchange, singing fee-fi, fiddly-i-o, where the deer and the antelope row, oh, 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 fee-fi, fiddly-i-ho, ho, ho. Susanna, won't you blow your horn? Yeah! Thank you.
to sit around the fire, telling tales about the days of old. We'd reminisce about the times we missed. I reminisce about the stories we told. And as the fire got to dying down, the night would start to turn back to day. And then someone would say, yes, sir, yes, sir, those days were fine. Yes, sir, yes, sir, but these are the good old times. When we're old and our memories are great, if we have any left at all, in the spring we'll watch leaves being born, and then we'll watch them change in the fall. We'll wish that we were young again, tell that story about your wedding day. Life was short, but we had each other, and then one of us will say, yes, sir, yes, sir, those days were fine. Yes, sir, yes, sir, but these are the good old times.
Got the coffee ready? Try to get Justin to wake up.
Hey, Justin, wake up!
Nothing. He likes his sleep, I guess.
I figured we'd give this a shot.
Rubber snake. Let's go. Be very quiet.
Wake up! Why do you see that? It sure got you up, didn't it?
Oh, thanks for coffee.
Hey, no problem.
If there was a time to sing this old tune, I figured that time would be now. 'Cause today will be yesterday tomorrow. Ain't it crazy how time works out? There ain't nothing like a good old friend. There ain't many friends like you. Great stories, but I think we can all agree. Yes, sir, yes, sir, those days were fine. Yes, sir, yes, sir, but these are the good old times. These are the good old times.
My name is Red Mila Cody, and I am of the Red Ochre Cheek clan, also known as the Red Bottom People clan. Yate.
Yate.
Joe and Justin.
Can you tell us more about that word? How do you pronounce that?
You say ya.
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 Te.
Te. Ya-te.
Ya.
Te. Ya-te.
And that's a greeting.
It's just our way of you know, saying it is good. It's beautiful.
So we were making food the other night.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about what we were making and what the history is behind that food?
So we had some ichi, which is intestines wrapped around the sheep fat. And we had corn, which is a very essential part of our culture. We had tsikaadeze, which I learned from my grandma to, you know, make the tortillas over the open fire on the grill. The fire is, you know, we perceive the fire as our, you know, as our grandpa or grandma.
Uh-oh.
We view in the Diné society ourselves equal with nature, with everything that we coexist with in this world, from the sun, the earth, to Yad Hitka, Father Sky, you know, to these beautiful rocks here. There's life, you know, we have to be respectful, and we've lost a lot of that respect, you know, in our society, because we are constantly taking from the earth. My grandmother was an amazing woman, and I learned a lot from her. She really stressed and emphasized to me the importance of ke. And ke is kinship, ke is community. So it's never just me. My grandmother taught me, you don't just say me. You think for all your people. Even when I said ya'at'e, I acknowledged ya'a, the father sky. Ah, na'asan hima, mother earth. Teh, all that is here. A part of our culture has always involved taking enough, but also putting back. So we have to remember that we have to be respectful, even to each other. Growing up as a Diné, Nahitha, Diné, meaning Navajo, Nahitha, African American, was very difficult because I was different and because of the color of my skin, obviously. But my grandma would tell me, you know, Binti Adal, Tkeya Diné, Stanin, let him talk. You are a Navajo woman and be proud of who you are. The holy people made us who we are, and we had no choice in our making. And kinship does not discriminate. You know, it's about the wholeness. It's about the community. It's about the strength that lies in that. Being there and supporting each other and loving each other and helping each other. And also we believe in our Diné philosophy of walking in beauty, to strive towards walking in beauty before you, behind you, below you, above you, and through the words that you share with those you come in contact with.
All right, Justin.
All right.
This is it.
This is the last one.
We've come to the end of the journey, haven't we?
That's right. It's been a long one. It's been a good one.
Well, we've been working on this tune here. I think this is a good one for the end.
All right, let's go out on this one.
Here we go.
Close your sleepy eyes, my little buckaroo. While the light of western skies shines down on you, it's time to rest. Another day is through, so go to sleep, my little buckaroo. Yippee-yi-yo. Mighty tree from a little acorn grew, and even Buffalo Bill was a kid once too. Don't you know it's time you're rounding up a dream or two? So go to sleep, my little buckaroo. Yippee-yi-yo, yippee-yi-yay. There are no more songs left to play. Move 'em out, move 'em in. Every story has to end, but some stay in your heart. They go around and round, they get lost and then found, 'cause the end is just another place to start. Oh!
1, 2, 3. What's for chow? My life pen is drooling.
Well, tonight's just a can of old whistleberries and some skunk eggs.
Aw, horse feathers.
You're sitting in your tent. It's late. You can't fall asleep. The wind's blowing. You're thinking to yourself, is there a grizzly bear outside? Is that a raccoon I hear? I win! Ah! Quicker than you can say blusteration, that buster was dusted.
Yeehaw! Sounds like that bronc buster was nothing more than a boogered up tenderfoot.
Man, I wish I was back home in my little bed.
Just wait till those old prairie tenders start tearing up Jake.
Coyotes? They'll have me running worse than a cat in a room full of rockers.
It's hard, and you gotta spit your toothpaste out on the plants. But this is like way cooler than staying at home.
It's gonna all go once, going twice. Now it's sold, 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 alive and livestock. It's sold,
reach, 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 reach.
Yeah.
Oh, winner back there.
Holy cow.
We're gonna let you go on that one.
Our concert is over.
We'll see you next year.
Okay. Are they booing? Are they booing?